Hi students, and welcome back to Bankexamstoday.com. And today we are going to start a 5-minute vocabulary video lesson series on the YouTube, because vocabulary is important to improve your writing skills and to get good marks in your English section. Because whenever we are doing the reading comprehension section in the English exam, you will get at least 2 or 3 questions based on the vocabulary. Either it can be fill in the blanks associated with the vocabulary, or it can be to find the synonyms and antonyms. So basically, vocabulary is very important if you are willing to improve your English writing skills, and if you are willing to improve your scores in the English section of any competitive exam. Okay, so this video is going to be very short, because learning vocabulary for 30 to 40 minutes is quite boring. I don't want to bore you, therefore the video is only for 5 minutes. And in these 5 minutes, you are going to learn 5 new words every day. So that is very good. Without wasting any second, I'm going to tell you the very first word in today's video, which is vacillation. Vacillation is like you are unable to decide which path to choose. You have many options in front of you and you are still thinking which option you are going to opt. So basically, vacillation is like moving here and there and here and there without no particular decision. This is your inability to decide between different opinions, different actions and decisions. Okay, so the synonyms for vacillation are indecision, because you are not ready to take any decision. Uncertainty, you are not sure, you are not certain. Doubt, clear? And hesitation, fluctuation. Fluctuation because your decisions are keep changing, you are changing your mind. So that is vacillation. Antonyms are remain. It means you are staying at a place. You have decided that I'm going to do this. Then continue. Continue means you are not going here and there. You're just continuing on the similar path. Hold and persist. You are staying at the same place, or you're moving in the same direction without any distractions that where you should go. Example for vacillation are the very I have only one example here. He could never pledge himself frankly in one sense or the other, and this vacillation prevented him from attaining any decisive result. It means he is unable to decide what he wants in the life, and that is vacillation. Moving to the another word, that is solace. Solace, for example, you are very upset and now you need someone's support in order to get some consolation. You go to your best friend. So your best friend is your solace, because that best friend or that person you love is providing you comfort and consolation in times of distress or sadness. For example, you are extremely sad and you need someone to console you. That is your solace. It means that is your comfort. It can be your best friend, your mother, your father, anyone you like, or any place where you find solace, where you find comfort. Like if I'm sad, I go to a gurdwara. So that is my solace. It provides me solace, it provides me comfort. Antonyms of solace are discord, because we are unable to make peace with the other person or with our emotions. Disharmony, agitation. Example, many worried souls find solace in religion. It means whenever a soul is worried, whenever a person is worried, they seek solace in their religion. Moving to the next question, that is angst. Angst is a continuous feeling of being worried about something that is very insignificant in your life. For example, you are worried about a 20 marks test. You're continuously worrying about it, how much marks or how many marks I'm going to get in the exam. That is the feeling of angst. You are worried over something trivial, which is not that important in your life, but still you are worried. So angst is the feeling of anxiety. You are fearful. Then you get the antonyms. Antonyms that you are calm. There is calmness around you. You have the confidence to do whatever you want to do. You are not worried about anything insignificant in your life. and then there is happiness. You are not sad, you are not fearful. Example, as the economy continues to worsen, the economic situation are worsening, many of the nation's citizens feel angst about their financial troubles. It means they are worried. Then comes dexterity. Dexterity, if you were born in 1990s, you must have seen the cartoon Dexter. He had a laboratory for himself and he used to keep on experimenting things. So dexterity is skill in performing some task, especially with your hands, that needs the balance of your mind and your hands. That is dexterity. Okay, skill in performing task, especially with your hands. The synonyms are agility, nimbleness, ability, talent. Whatever you say, that is dexterity. It is just a fancy word to explain that he has a talent. Then antonyms, clumsiness. Someone who is very clumsy, does not like to keep things organized. Stupidity, insensitivity. You are not sensitive about the any task you are performing. That opposite of dexterity. Example, by great dexterity, he succeeded in turning public attention. It means his talent turned the public. Okay, he was able to attain the public attention with his dexterity, with his talent. The next word is rescind. Rescind, to cancel any legal agreement, any law or any order. Okay, for example, you had some agreement with your organization that you rescind, that is cancelled. Okay, so synonyms are reverse, abrogate, overturn, overrule, annul and nullify. Nullify, it means it has no significance now. I do not abide to the rules mentioned in the contract. That is rescind. You cancel all the legal agreements, all law and order. Then antonyms, you have to allow or approve whatever you have cancelled. You approve it or you start enforcing it or establishing it. So that is the antonyms. Then example, because of illegal alcohol sales, the government had to rescind the Prohibition Act. It means when government banned the sale of alcohol, people started selling it illegally. So the government has to cancel the order of selling alcohol. So that cancelling is rescind. So these are the 5 words we did today, and I hope you like this video. I will see you in the next video. If you have any query, just drop an email on this email ID. And do practice these words with your day-to-day vocabulary. Try to write these words in the various sentences, in various context of the sentences. And then let me know if you face any issue. So have a nice day. And thank you once again for watching this video.